The four-man Arsenal team arrived 10 minutes early for today's hearing, led by chairman Peter Hillwood. Evidence was also given by club secretary Ken Fryer, the Arsenal manager George Graham, as well as club skipper Tony Adams. Norwich City, headed by their chairman Robert Chase, followed a few minutes later. Arsenal's plea during the two-hour hearing at Lancaster Gate was that their players had become involved in an attempt to defuse the situation, but the FA felt it wasn't good policy for footballers to run the length of the pitch to do so. At one point, 21 players appeared to be part of a mass brawl. The FA said Arsenal's smaller fine reflected their proportion of the blame. Graham Kelly, the FA's chief executive, said he would have liked the option of deducting points from both clubs, but the league's constitution wouldn't allow it.
We have taken the decision we have today to send a clear signal that we do find clubs responsible, and indeed we find managers responsible for the actions of their players. It's a responsibility that cannot easily be escaped. Indeed, that is what the managers are paid for.
Arsenal's George Graham said he felt the verdict was fair. The Police Federation, who've been demanding legal action against guilty players, said tonight they weren't fully satisfied.
The Police Federation are extremely disappointed. Here was an opportunity for the football authorities to get their act in order and to show players that they would not tolerate the kind of behaviour we saw at that particular game. They fluffed it, unfortunately. We are disappointed, very disappointed.
What would you have liked to have seen the FA do to the two sides?
I believe that warranted, that action on that field that day warranted a reduction in league points.
The FA believe the current relationship with the police is a good one, but they accept that football isn't above the law. Graham Miller, Thames News.